Chapter 2. Nolan Titan, the commander of the facility, watched as security forces scattered to find the intruders.
What is the point in having the most secure facility if the personnel within can't locate a single intruder?
A young officer approached him, looking very sheepish. Nolan gave him a look.
Sir, we may have more than one intruder. Squad 7 leader reports he has lost contact with two security guards. Last report was that they were heading to secure the detention section.
Nolan rolled his eyes.
Have you sent some men to their last reported position?
That's just it, sir. They were en route with the rest of the squad. The squad leader only noted they were missing when they got to the detention section.
Then send some men to trace their route!
Before the officer could answer, another officer approached them.
Sir, Squad 8 has engaged an intruder.
I want him alive!
That might be easier said than done.
Nolan watched on one of the monitors as the guards fought the intruder.
Nolan's eyes widened. The intruder wasn't an ordinary intruder. Suddenly, an idea formed in his mind.
Change of plans.
Taurus was scanning the corridor as they moved down it. So this place is some kind of genetic facility.
Obviously. What they are doing here is illegal, but they are still Alliance personnel and will be treated as such.
But what would be the point in creating monsters like that? Taurus asked. Owen considered for a moment.
I doubt they were the finished product. Probably dead ends or failed prototypes. As they neared a corner, they could hear the shouting and sounds of a fight. Pressing against the wall, Owen peered around the corner where he spotted a group of guards fighting hand to hand with someone.
I think we've found our Marines, he whispered and moved in closer.
But as Owen watched the fight, he saw that there was only one person fighting. It wasn't a Marine. It wasn't even human. Ryuk was running on pure reflexes. He had never fought this many unarmed opponents in a single fight.
He couldn't use his energy weapon because of some kind of dampening field that when fired caused an energy weapon to backblast. It reminded him too much of what recently happened to Blaine.
These humans were good. A little too good. As Ryuk caught one fist, two more made contact with him. His armor absorbed most of the impact, but it still caused moments of distraction.
Just got to hold on a little longer, Ryuk thought as he felt the energy building within him.
Ryuk first found he had telekinetic abilities during a fight with a drone Yutrell had built. General Xeno had ordered that his fighting abilities be honed.
But Yutrell had built this drone a little too well,
and Ryuk found himself pinned by the drone's feet. By instinct, he reached out for something, anything, and suddenly found a blade in his hand.
According to the Daleks watching, the blade had suddenly flew off the table into Ryuk's hand.
It was also at that moment Ryuk found his combat skills were more suited to swordplay than blaster. Yutrell had always known of Ryuk's abilities, but often said he had to learn about them for himself, rather than be told. He practiced as often as he could with the abilities, but it was only now becoming possible for him to use it in combat. He suddenly felt the well fill and crossed his arms over his chest, then forcibly extended both arms, opening up his hands,
sending an invisible bubble of kinetic energy radiating out from him, catching all the guards and forcing them against the wall's floor and ceiling.
Ryuk caught his breath and sensed the presence of two more humans, but one of them felt familiar. He turned and spotted one of the humans duck back around the corner. He walked towards them and was greeted by two raised rifles.
Don't move, Owen commanded.
Ryuk's hands went up in a mocking display. You got me, I surrender. Then, without warning, in a blur of speed, Ryuk kicked the weapon out of Taurus's hands and pulled the rifle out of Owen's, throwing it to the ground.
You were saying? Ryuk said with a grin.
What are you? Owen asked. One of the experiments got loose? Ryuk took a step back.
Hardly.
I assume you are here to destroy this facility.
No. We were sent to find out what was going on. We didn't even know this facility was here.
Do you know? Owen felt an odd sensation when looking at this creature. He could not see its eyes through the tinted visor of its helmet, but something felt almost familiar.
Ryuk snorted.
Well, I'm here to blow it up. Places like this make me feel sick. He moved back down the corridor.
Taurus gave Owen a glance.
What exactly is going on here? Owen watched as Ryuk pulled a large katana-like sword out of the wall and slid it into a scabbard fastened onto his belt.
I'll show you what's going on here, he said as he walked off down the corridor.
Owen and Taurus picked up their weapons and followed. They caught up with Ryuk as he was working on a door control panel.
I take it you've seen the small lab down the hall?
Ryuk asked as he pulled wires out of the panel.
Yeah, right before we were attacked by two guards, Owen said.
The creatures in those vats were failed versions. They are taking the strongest non-human species and taking the best bits to merge with their own. The control panel burst and the door slid open.
The Alliance isn't in the business of creating monsters, Owen said as Ryuk stepped into the room.
Then you might want to have a word with the commander of this place.
Owen followed Ryuk in and his jaw dropped. Inside, laying in cryotubes, were hundreds of humans.
What in the name of all of this holy is this?
Torres said as he followed Owen inside.
Suddenly, the door at the other end opened and guards poured into the room.
Owen turned around in time to see more guards coming through the door they had just used. All three raised their hands. They were dragged to a detention area. Ryuk was stripped of his armor and weapons, but put up a fight when it came to his helmet. Several prolonged zaps with the stun batons and they had removed the helmet. Ryuk tried to keep his face from Owen's, but was spun around as they were brought to the cells.
Ryuk finally looked at Owen, who couldn't believe what he saw.
Ryuk?
Ryuk rolled his eyes.
Hello, brother, he said as they were pushed into their separate cells.